now. It will start when we go into data frames a little more. I think it'll start making a little more. So in this case, we have a data frame. And like I said, it's very similar to what you would see in Excel. It's usually when you input a CSV file, it's usually a data frame. Every column can be thought of as a variable. And then each column, this is just a rule, has to be of a different type or can be of a different type. So the entire column has to be one type. As I said earlier, if you have a totally numeric column, but then you have one character somewhere in that column, say it's 200 rows long, it will be forced to be a character variable. So keep that in mind. It's something to look out for. And as I said last week, I believe I went over this very quickly. When we have a data frame, if we want to refer to one single column within that data frame, we use our dollar sign. So we have our data frame, our dollar sign, and state. And state is a column within location.dataframe. So I'm going to go in real quick here. So in this case, you can use this matrix function in order to create a data frame. And that's what I'm going to do here, actually. So we have our city.state vector. We're creating this. So they're all of the same type. So I can use that matrix function to decide, and I want to create a data frame with it. So this will look exactly like we did what we did earlier. So we have my city state. You'll see these first four values are cities. And the second values, Texas, Pennsylvania, are the states that these cities are in. So it wouldn't make much sense for me to fill by row. In this case, I want to do by row equals false. And we'll see what that looks like in a second. And I wanted to put dimension names in here, just like I showed before. So we have our dimensions, we have our list with our row names and our column names. But I don't want this to be a matrix. For some reason, I want this to be a data frame. In order to change a matrix to a data frame,